Fluid Power System, Module 4, Pneumatic Control System, Lecture 4, Control Valves, Part 2. Disclaimer. This PPT has been prepared by referring many sources which include figures, diagrams from internet as well as from the prescribed test books and reference books. I do not claim any originality in preparing this video or PPT. This PPT or video is exclusively for purpose of education, not for any financial gains. I wholeheartedly thank all those who have directly or indirectly contributed to do this PPT and video. Pressure control valves. Compared with the hydraulic system, few control valves are brought into use in pneumatic system also. The pressure control valve control the pressure of the air flowing through the valve or confine the system controlled by the valve. There are three types of pressure control valves. One is pressure limiting valve, pressure sequence valve and pressure regulator or pressure reducing valve. Then working principle is same as the hydraulic system. How they will work in the hydraulic system, the same principle they will work in the pneumatic system also. Only the working medium is going to be changed. In the hydraulic system we'll use liquid, in pneumatic system we'll use the compressed air or any other gases. Pressure limiting valve prevents pressure in a system from rising above a permissible maximum. So it will prevent the pressure in the system from rising above a permissible maximum. The permissible maximum we need to set by the person who is set what is the pressure he required. So it will prevent the pressure to rise above from that particular set pressure. The construction and features limiting valve is shown in figure. It is a standard feature of compressed air production plant but is hardly ever used in pneumatic controls. They will use normally in the pressure like compressed air production plants. These valves perform a safety relief function by opening to the atmosphere if the predetermined pressure is exceeded in the system. So it will release the pressurized air to the atmosphere if the pressure reached the predetermined level, thus releasing excess pressure to the atmosphere. As soon as pressure is thus relieved to the desired figure and the valve is going to closed again by spring force. So if the pressure increased to the set pressure, then it released to the atmosphere, and when it reached the required set pressure, automatically it will close the opening or close the supply to the atmosphere. This is for that reason it is called as it is a pressure limiting valve. It will safeguard the pneumatic system. Non-return valve. Non-return valves permit flow of air in one direction only, the other direction through the valve being at all times blocked to the airflow. So it will allow flow of air in only one direction, other direction is always under the blocked condition. These valves are designed so that the check is additionally loaded by the downstream air pressure. The check is additionally loaded by the downstream air pressure, thus supporting the non-return action. Among the various types of non-return valves available, those preferentially employed in pneumatic controls are as follows: check valve, shuttle valve, quick exhaust valve and two pressure valve. The first one is check valve. The simplest type of non-return valve is the check valve. that one you can show in the figure. So it has a spring loaded moving component that will allow fluid flow in only one direction, right, which completely block air flow in one direction, which permitting flow in the opposite direction with the minimum pressure loss across the wall. As soon as the inlet pressure in the direction of the free flow develops a force greater than the internal spring, then the check is lifted clear the valve seat. This check in such valve may be plug, ball or plate or diaphragm type of check will be there, right? These kind of depending on the like on the ball type of will cause ball check valve, and the plate type will called as a disc or a plate type of check valve or the diaphragm kind of check valve also available in the market. Next we'll have the shuttle valve. The shuttle valve is an automatic type of direction control valve with three ports and two position characteristics. It will have the only the two position operation, but it has a three ports. This is based on three port body with a moving valve element in the form of spool or shuttle or a ball. The moving element will be in the form of spool, shuttle or ball. You can see the sketch in that one. This will be the moving spool. So depending on the A and B ports are the pressure ports, air supply ports. Depending on the pressure which side you supplied, according to that one, it will close the opposite side port, right? C will be the always output port, right? So if the both side pressure supplied at a time with the equal pressure, then also the output will going to be get. This one is the symbol which is used in the hydraulic circuit diagrams. The working of a shuttle valve consists of if it is a construction, it consists a valve body and a synthetic valve element. The synthetic valve element may be as a ball moving inside the bore of the valve housing. There are three openings called as A, B and C. A and B are the input ports, C is the outlet port. If the pressure of air at A is higher than the pressure at B, then the ball moves towards B port and B port is going to be blocked, thus connecting port A and C. Nothing but flow will take place from port A to C. Similarly, when the pressure of air at B is higher than pressure at A, then the ball moves towards the port A and block the port A, so that the fluid or the air will pass through the port from port B to C by connecting B and C. Next, if the air is fed simultaneously with the both the port, now from A port and B port, then air moves towards the C port, either from port A or B or from both. These elements will also called as OR gate. This will have the circuit. If you wanted to use the shuttle valve in a circuit to control a single acting cylinder, so with the two control valves, direction control valves, this is a 3x2 direction control valves with the spring return. So initially what you required, if you press a first valve, first direction control valve, then air will supply to port A, then air will supply to port A of a shuttle valve and the cylinder will move forward direction, right? At the same time, after if you shut off this one, it will return back due to the spring force in the single acting cylinder. Then whenever you wanted to operate using the valve 2, then if you press the valve 2 against the spring, then from the pressure line the port B will be connected to the shuttle valve, so the air will supply through the valve 2. So this kind of application is used where we wanted to control a single cylinder with a two different location, with a two different location, right? Then you can use this wall. Where using a two walls, you can control a single cylinder. Nothing but a single acting cylinder. Next, we'll have a twin pressure valve. It has two ports and one outlet port, as it is what you studied in the shuttle valves. There are also two input ports, one output port. Here also two input ports and one outlet port. A two pressure valve requires two pressurized input to allow an output from itself. There you required only in shuttle valve, you required only one side pressurized air. But in the twin pressure valve, both the side, nothing but it required a two pressure valve in two positions. Then only it can able to operate. Right? This valve has two inputs, say as 12 and 14. Two input as 12 and 14 and one output. One outlet port is this one. If the compressed air is applied to the X, if the compressed air is applied to 12 port and input or one more input port of 14, the spool moves to block the flow. If you supply from any one side, say example, if you supply air pressure, compressed air from the 12, spool will move and it will block the port number 14. And the same way, if you supply the pressurized air from the port number 14, the spool will move towards the 12 and it will block the 12 port. So no signal will come to the outlet port. If the signal is required in the outlet port, then both 12 and 14 need to supply at a time. Both the input from 12 and 14 you need to supply at a time. The compressed air flow through the valve and signal appears in the outlet port. If the both the sides of compressed air is supplied in 12 and port at a time, then the same compressed air will get as in outlet port. This is all the circuit. See, both the side you require a pressure, then only the spool will stay at the center, so and it will not block any ports, so it will give the supply to the outlet port from the input. So it required both the sides should be on, then only it will give the outlet. So this will be used as an AND gate. Here you can see the sketch with an explanation. See here. Here, when an output is produced, if both input signals are fed, this valve has three ports, 1, 2 and 3 port, A, B and C. Port A and B are the input signals and port C is the output port. When a signal is fed through A, spool moves to the right and blocks the passage from A to C. Similarly, when the signal fed through the B, the spool moves towards the left block passage and block the passage from B to C, it going to be blocked. If the signal fed simultaneously through A and B, then the spool remains in the neutral position and air will pass through C from both A and B. This will be the application circuit diagram of usage of twin pressure valve. See here also we will use the two valves what we used like in a shuttle valve, and cylinder which is used is single acting cylinder with the spring return, right? And the two control valves with the push button operated with the spring return condition, and one twin pressure valve. And there is a supply from the compressor to both the control valves, nothing but direction control valves, DCVs. When you push the push button 1, say 1 to 2 is get connected and the air will supply will given to X. When the air supply is given to X, nothing but see here in the A, the valve itself it is going to be close the connection between A to C. In the such way, if you operate only the direction control valve 2, so one is almost released, so there is no air supply from X. The next condition, if you press only the direction control valve 2 actuate, then 1 to 2 is get connected of a second direction control valve. Compressed air will flow towards the Y port, nothing but here in the B. So if you supply from the B port, what will happen? Automatically the spool will move towards the A. Automatically it will block flow from B to C. There is no supply to C. Then when the twin pressure valve will operate, both the side, both the direction control valve should be on, and so that the pressure, the compressed air pressure, will be supplied both at a time from X and Y at a time, right? Then see here, from A and B both side you have a pressure, then it will be connected to the outlet port C, and here it is Z, so that the cylinder will move forward direction against the spring force. If you release any valve, automatically the air pressure will go to the exhaust, because it will be controlled by a spring return actuator is used in this system. Next we'll have the quick exhaust valve. It consists three ports, right, as same what you studied in shuttle valve and the twin pressure valve, right? Here also we have one inlet pressure, one cylinder port and one exhaust port. Here it is the difference. In the previous two direction in shuttle valve and a twin pressure valve, so two are the input valve, one is the outlet port, nothing but which is connected to the cylinder actuation. But here one input pressure port and one is the actuation port, nothing but it is connected to the cylinder, and one is exhaust port, directly exhaust to the atmosphere, right? Exhaust port in a body and valve element is flexible ring. The valve element is a flexible ring. When the P is connected to high pressure, see in the sketch, when the P is connected to high pressure, right, the valve element block the port R, nothing but outlet port is going to be blocked by a valve element, and air flows from P to A. The connection will take place from pressure port to A port, nothing but an actuation port. When the valve is detached, nothing but when the supply, compressed air supply, is cut off, then automatically due to the air pressure from the actuator will retract a return flow, right? That will block the pressure port, and it will the reverse or the return port or exhaust port will get open. The air will flow to the exhaust port. We'll have one more sketch and we'll see. Here we can see, right? So in the quick exhaust valve used to exhaust the cylinder air quickly to the atmosphere. We can see the cylinder, right? Single acting cylinder with a spring return, right? And which is air flowed to the piston end, that we need to exhaust quickly to the atmosphere, right? In many applications, especially with a single acting cylinder, it is common practice to increase the piston speed during retraction. We want the retraction should be faster. Then in that conditions, because if you retract the cylinder fast, the cycle time will going to be reduced. If the speed is increased, the cycle time of the system or actuation is going to be reduced. So we wanted to exhaust the exhaust we required very quickly. So what is the higher speed of the piston speed is possible by reducing the resistance to the flow of exhaust air during the motion of the cylinder, right? The resistance can be reduced by expelling the exhaust air to the atmosphere quickly by using a quick exhaust valve. So here, when you operate the valve, direction control valve, the air will supply to the pressure port from A, so it will go to the cylinder piston end, the cylinder will move forward direction, right, with respect to the flow rate which is supplied from the direction control valve. The speed of the actuator will going to depend on the flow rate you have supplied through the direction control valve. But return speed is how quickly you exhaust the air which is already inside the piston end. So that depending on the that quick exhaust, the speed of the return is going to be depends. So the quick exhaust valve is used, so the air which is there is no any restriction in this one. After the actuation of this one, if the air will directly go to the quick exhaust valve directly to the atmosphere, so there is no restriction. So the retraction speed will be very less and cylinder will retract in faster and rate. Next we'll have the flow control valve. The function of the flow control valve is self evident from its name, nothing but it will control the flow. A flow control valve regulates the rate of air flow. The controlled action is limited to the air flow passing through the valve when it is open. The maintaining set volume per unit of time. The figure shows the variable restriction type of flow, right? Flow control valve, the inlet type of flow control valve it is, in which the flow can be set by turning this particular screw that will increase or decrease the opening of this valve, so that the from the input supply the flow will go to the output depending on the restriction you provide in the flow control valve. If there is no restriction, the flow will be takes normal with the high flow. If you have a restriction, automatically the flow will going to be reduced. Flow control with the integrated check valve. The internal construction of a non-return type of pneumatic control valve with an inbuilt valve is shown in figure. The free flow is allowed from inlet to outlet port, right? But flow from outlet port to inlet port is restricted. Mostly a ball and spring type of check valve is used, but there are many other varieties of design available from various manufacturers of such devices. The flow control can be applied in two different ways: metering or meter out. Meter in is the method of controlling a rate of air flow as it enters a cylinder. When meter in, the cylinder will move rapidly with high force and efficiency, but the motion of the piston is prone to spongy and unpredictable movement. When the meter out, the cylinder velocity is more stable and repeatable, but efficiency and dynamic force are lost to the energy required to push past the flow control. Regardless, the most pneumatic applications operate using a meter out flow control because the disadvantages are easy to overcome by increasing upstream pressure. Time dependent control. See, this is a time dependent control valve. It has a inlet port 1. See, 1 is the inlet port. From 1 to 2 supply you need to give. By operating this valve, 1 to 2 need to connect so that the pressurized air flow from 1 to 2. 1 to 2 in the flow need to take place. To operate this valve, we have a one more port as a 12. This is the pilot signal, air signal we need to supply you. Or the operation of this valve is going to be depending on the pilot signal. That air supplied from the port number 12, which is through the needle control valve to the chamber. This chamber is used as a time dependent. See, the time required to fill this chamber will going to be the operating or time dependent of this particular valve. That much time the valve is going to be operate in two different ways, whether on delay or off delay. Those things we'll study further in the next slide. First we'll see the time. Say example, the time required to fill this one, it required a 5 seconds. So 5 seconds delayed if you operate the valve by giving a supply to this one, it won't give the immediate actuation. It will give after 5 minutes only. After 5 minutes or 5 seconds. If say example 5 minutes. After 5 minutes it will take time to fill this. This one is a 5 seconds. Then after 5 seconds what will happen? The air will push this stem. You are able to see this stem. This stem will going to be pushed by using the compressed air. Right? Then while pushing that one, see here, that will come move downwards and push the main spool of the valve. When you push this one, see here, the air compressed air push this one. The main spool, when you push against the spring force, the 1 to 2 is get connected. 1 to 2 is get connected. So this is the time delay valve. So to make it valve actuation after the supply to the direction control valve, but immediately it should not act. It will act after some time. That delay will going to be depending on this, the chamber which, how much time is required to air to fill in this particular chamber. You can see the same with the simpler sketch. There is a moving stem against the spring force. Right, pump to A we need to connect, but due to the spring force it will be under the closed condition. What will happen when you give the signal through the inlet port here, through the check valve or through the needle valve? It will take time to fill this chamber first. After filling this chamber, the air pressure will act on all sides of the particular chamber. In that time, there is a moving spool. The same air pressure will act on this moving spool. If the air pressure is more than the spring pressure, the spool will going to be pushed by the compressed air. While pushed, the port A will get open. So the supply will take place from port to P, port to outlet, from the pressure port to the actuation port. We have one more sketch. See here how you are going to operate. See, the from the compressed air we have a supply to this time dependent port, but pump to C we need to connect, but is under the closed condition. To actuate that one, you have a one more actuator, so it's a push button direction control valve. When you push this one, the air supply will take place like this. Air supply will take place like this and it will flow. So example, I will take the red color. See, it will take like this. The flow will take place, right? When you push this one, then that will come to this location through the needle valve, it will flow in. And it will take time to fill this particular chamber. After filling this chamber, whatever, that same air pressure will push this spool. When this push spool will try to move towards this one, then from this particular pressure port, P and C is get connected. So this will help the some delay in operating that particular valve. Where we required, sometime it requires. Right, the valve should not actuate immediately. After some delay only it need to actuate. How we'll see the application or how the time delay things will work. Say the with the same sketch. Say is a one direction control valve with the symbols. The previous sketch was using the schematic diagram. This is with respect to the circuit diagram. The valve, when this is operate, P to A is get connected, air will flow through the flow control valve and it has a chamber. The time required to fill this chamber, after the filling this chamber, this will push the pilot signal to the next valve, which is inbuilt valve in the time delay valve, so that pump to A is get connect, so the air will flow towards the piston and the piston will do the actuation. Next we'll have the sketch where timing diagram of all four types of pneumatic delay valves. When you say pneumatic delay, there are two types of delay. One is on delay and off delay. Please remember, one is on delay and off delay. First we will see the on delay valve. Nothing but when you on it, it need to actuate after some time. That delay will called as on delay. Right here, the depending on the in the valves also we have two types. One is normally closed type and normally open type. Say example, it is normally under the closed type. This one we need to on when the air supply given to the time delay valve. how it is get on? See, if the signal is given to the time delay wall, so it will take some time to delay. That is the time required to fill this particular chamber. After the filling of that particular chamber only, it will push the spool of the time delay wall so that 1 to 2 is get connected. So that is the time delay. See, first, even though if a supply directly given to the time delay wall, after some time delay, it will on. When it off, automatically it will off. Immediately it will off. Off will not going to be delay. Only the on application is going to be delay. In the same way, if it is a direction control wall, it is normally open type of wall. That is already is under the open condition. We need to close it. But the signal which is given to the time delay wall is on only. But it will off. See here. Because it is normally open wall. If it is already open wall, it will close after the actuation. If it is already closed type of wall, after the actuation, it will open. So in this condition, it is normally open type of wall. We need to close that one after time delay. So you switched on the time delay wall. After some time delay, it will give the signal. That signal is off signal. That signal is off signal, nothing but the valve is already open, that need to be closed. So the valve which is already open, that need to be closed. That is with respect to the on delay. With respect to the on delay, with the open type of, normally open type of valve and normally closed type of valve. Next we'll see the off delay valve. With respect to the same kind of application, with the open type, normally open type valve and normally closed type valve. How it will operate? See, we have first example, I have a normally closed valve. We need to open this one. So what will have? Initially it is under the on condition. Nothing but input signal to the valve is on. When it is on, so it will be under the on condition only. This valve we need to actuate to off. So when it off, no, after some time delay only the main particular valve will going to be off. After time delay, this valve is going to be actuated to the off. So what will happen when it is off? The already closed valve will go open. Don't confuse the off and on. When you say off delay, that is with respect to the time delay valve. And closed valve will get open towards with respect to the in that particular valve. As I said initially itself, the valve will have always two types of valve. Right, one is normally open type valve and normally closed type valve, depending on the application. If you wanted to cut off the supply, it is normally under the always open condition. We need to cut off the supply when the time delay valve is on. The same way it will work. When the time delay valve is off, so it need to cut off the supply. Because it is already under the closed condition, we need to on. The same way here, the second one, normally under the open valve, we need to close. Open valve we need to close. What will happen? The on signal is given to the at a time. So both valve is on condition. When it is off, it will take, it will make a delay to off that particular valve or to generate the off signal. The off signal may be the towards depending on the valve. Off signal is generated, but towards the valve, the valve if it is under the on condition, nothing but normally open, it will close after time delay. If it is normally closed type of valve, it will open after time delay. Right, this is with respect to the on delay and off delay, nothing but how you require the response, whether you require a response immediately on, so the time delay will going to be response lately. The other direction controls all are will response fastly. But time delay valve will going to be respond slowly depending on the time. The time also you can set by setting the flow. The flow control if you set, no, in the time delay valve near the chamber there is a needle valve, flow control valve. There you can set the time delay, whether you require a 5 minutes or 5 seconds, that you can control by controlling the flow rate of the fluid which is fed to the time delay valve. So thank you to watching my videos with respect to the DCET. all the best for your CET exam. For any information or any clarification, you can contact me in the number 9900092934, or you can mail me in above mail ID sandeepmysore07@gmail.com. Once again, thank you and all the best for your CET exam.